to the girl I used to be. I remember how you'd associate the word beautiful with everyone else except yourself, because they told you that the definition of beauty is fair skin and perfect figure. They portrayed that the ones who cannot take your eyes off from are the only ones who get everything in life. They told you to add layers of cosmetics on your face and disguise who you are, to conform and be like everyone else. And you believed. You believed in what the fairness skin had to say about your beauty. You believed every time someone told you, you were not the right weight. You couldn't find beauty in yourself, and so you turned a blind eye on everyone who did. You couldn't love yourself, and so you distanced from everyone who did. I wish that I could go back in time and tell you about the day you decided to just be yourself and not hide in the layers. Because you were never meant to be them. You were always, ever, only meant to be you. About the day someone told you to be happy in your own skin. It was an ordinary day, an ordinary road, a casual conversation. Yet you hold those words dear, as if safeguarding a precious treasure. I wish I could tell you how people love you for the way you care, the way you treat others, the kindness you show, the way you smile in the hardest situations, the way you can make anyone laugh, the way you make people feel at ease around you, the way you listen and understand, the way you compliment and encourage, the way you try to show people the beauty in themselves they can't see. Your intellect, your passions, your genuineness, your honesty, your I won't give up on things, I love attitude. I wish I could tell you that there wasn't a second in your life that you haven't been loved. It's just that you couldn't see it. Or maybe you did. But you saw it as a mirage, an illusion that when the time comes, it will all disappear. They will leave and you will be alone again. I remember your stage fright and self-esteem issues. I remember how you thought that confidence is genetic and you will never have it. You always tried to find excuses to not participate for the fear of embarrassment. You tried to be invisible, just a part of the audience who admired the ones on stage. The ones who can hold a spotlight as if they were born to do just that. How? I wish I could tell you about the day someone told you that life is a play, where some choose to act, whereas some choose to sit in the audience and crib about the ones performing. About the day you gave yourself permission to fall as many times as it takes for you to learn something. I won't lie, you still have stage fright. Your heart still beats out of its cage every time you're about to go up on stage. But you never let it hold you back. You go up on stage every damn time and make the best of it. You now know that confidence is about practice. And anyone, I mean anyone, can build it. You were always academically good, not because you wanted to be at the top of the merit list, but because once in sixth grade, when you were sitting beside the smartest girl in class, you thought to yourself, if she can do it, why can't I? And that basically changed the way you pursue your academics. If someone can understand a concept, if someone can solve a problem, so can you. That's about it. You don't give up until you get it right. I remember how you always felt out of place, the feeling of not being enough, funny enough, smart enough, confident enough, beautiful enough. Your own insecurities never let you make good friends out of people. You always wondered, why would anyone want to be with me? You thought no one cared. You tried so hard to fit in, to be liked by people, that you forgot who you were. Or maybe you never found her. I wish I could go back in time and tell you about the day you started loving people with all your heart without having any self-doubts. When you gave out love, it returned to you multifold. You were never meant to fit in. You were enough as you were. All you ever had to do was believe. Believe in yourself. You were always scared of losing people. You still are. But now you have learned to let people go who don't want to stay any longer. I remember how scared you were of uncertainty, of things changing, of being in unknown surroundings. I wish I could tell you that now you embrace uncertainty with open arms. That now you aren't scared of change anymore. Because change leads to growth. What you are scared of more is being the same as you were yesterday. That now getting to know new people is kind of your favorite thing to do. I remember how you were drowning in a world of negatives looking for someone to paint it. I wish I could tell you about the day you decided to paint it yourself with all your favorite colors and how colorful life has been since then. When I read all the words you wrote, I couldn't believe that I wrote them, that I was you back then. And I know you wouldn't have believed that I am you right now. People might see you as a before picture and me as an after picture. But we are one. It took me to be you, to be who I am today. I remember all the times you felt unworthy, insignificant, as if you'll never amount to something. Love, listen to me. You were a caterpillar weaving a cocoon around itself, only to one day break out of it and take to the skies. I wish I could tell you how much I love you, how proud you make me every day, how grateful I am to be you. I wish I could tell you that you are worthy of everything in this world. That you are the writer of your story and that story is going to be the best you ever write. Now, every time you see someone struggling with self-doubt, you go up to them and tell them to have faith in the process. That everything falls into its right place with time.